ברוכים הבאים לגן לאומי הרודיון.
Welcome to the Herodion National Park of the Israel Nature and Parks Authority. The national park is located about 7 kilometers south of Beit Lechem in a desert area, and it's an historical archaeological site which includes King Herod's summer place, caves from the period of the Bar Kokhba revolt, and Herod's grave. What we see from here is Lower Herodion, at the center of which there was a large pool of water surrounded by pillars which originally had roofing. On the left there is a building with a dome, which is the Herodian bathhouse, and the excavations outside the pool complex are a Byzantine monastery, which was built 300 to 400 years after King Herod, but sits entirely on remnants from King Herod's period.
אבל הוא כולו יושב על השרידים מתקופת מלך הורדוס. נמצאים בנקודה כמעט הכי גבוהה של הר הרודיון.
We're almost at the highest point of the Herodion. From here you can see Jerusalem's southern neighborhood, Gilo, Har Choma, the French Hill, Mount Scopus, and the Mount of Olives. From here, if the visibility was better, we'd also see the graves of the cemetery of the Mount of Olives. We are more or less along the Temple Mount, and this had a big significance in choosing King Herod's grave site, and also in building the summer palace itself. We're at the peak of the Herodion, at almost the highest point on the mountain. The height here is 758 meters above sea level.
אנחנו נמצאים בפסגה של הרודיון, בנקודה כמעט הכי גבוהה בהר. הגובה פה זה 758 מטר מעל פני הים. בנקודה הזאת אנחנו רואים יפה מאוד את מדבר יהודה.
From this point, we can clearly see the Judean desert, the local communities such as Ma'ale Rechavam, Kfar Eldad above it, with the red roofs, and Nokdim. At the foot of the Herodion, the Stebar youth village, and of course the largest and oldest Jewish community in this area, Tkoa. All the communities in the area are mixed communities, meaning religious and non-observant people living there. Above Jewish Tekoa, you see the Arab village of Tekoa, where the center of the village, the peak of the hill, where the trees are, sit on the remnants of a Jewish village from the period of the Second Temple. And according to the Tanakh, the Bible, the prophet Amos lived in this village. And according to Chazal, our sages, he's also buried there.
He is the most famous resident of Tekoa, even though it's mentioned in several places in the Tanakh.
The wadi between Nokdim and Tekoa is Wadi Haritun, opposite Nokdim's water tower on the other side of the wadi. Do you recognize the water tower, the white tower there? There is the entrance to the Haritun cave, which is a nature reserve, the largest active karst cave in the Middle East. One can go in there with guidance and lighting. It's not recommended to visit the cave without a guide, but that's the second most important site here in the area in terms of natural assets, heritage, and landscape. This is the palace's synagogue. It's not a synagogue which belongs to Herod, of course. This was his dining room. But when the big revolt broke out about 66 CE, a group of zealots came here and conquered the place by force. We don't know who were the forces who sat here at that time, but they conquered the palace by force and settled inside it. They chose the largest room in the palace, added stone benches around it, and turned this room into a room that served the community's purposes. The zealots sat here for 6 years, from 66 to 72, meaning they lived here for 2 years after the temple was destroyed. We've entered a system of caverns from the period of the Bar Kokhba revolt. It's the largest system from the period of the revolt and is one of the largest underground systems in Israel. As of today, as a result of the Bar Kokhba warriors, the entire mountain is dug up from inside. Some of these passages are open to public visits. They are lit and don't require crawling, and in essence, anyone can visit. The Herodion, in my opinion, is today the only site where a Jew can feel the Bar Kokhba revolt and visit it freely. We're standing beside the latest and largest discovery in Herodion. About a year and a half ago, a private theater belonging to King Herod was discovered, and you're seeing its remnants right now. What's amazing is that it's likely that this theater was built for a one-time event, the visit of Marcus Agrippa, the deputy of Octavius Caesar in the year 15 BCE, and was demolished right after the visit.